Hello again. I'm back in the shop today with what appears to be a pretty rare snow tire. This is the Falken Winterpeak F-Ice 1, and my local distributor has hundreds of these in so many different sizes, and it's pretty much their bread and butter for a snow tire this year, and I can't find an independent review of it anywhere. I think maybe there was one quick review on simpletire.com, but it really wasn't informative. And the point of this video isn't to give it a review either, because these aren't going on my car, but I thought I'd at least give you guys a closer look at it, because the only videos online are from Falken themselves, which don't really show it up close, and obviously it's biased, so we don't know if it's, you know, as good as a snow tire as they say. I'd love to find out. These are going on my brother-in-law's car a couple days from now. And maybe I'll get a chance to drive it this winter, but I'm not sure. So before I put them on, I thought we'd take a look at it. And I'll show you how it differs from some other snow tires. I've got a couple different ones up here. The main one is in 205/55/16, is the General Ultimax Ultimax Arctic 12, which is going on the Hyundai behind me this year. It's my favorite generic, you know, do everything snow tire. It's very deep, very knobby, and it goes through deep snow like crazy. I mean, it's my favorite snow tire that you may have never heard of. And then here's some Pirellis. These are more specialty in staggered fitment, but you can see how the tread pattern on all three of these is really very different. Let's pull down the General. So between these two tires, I believe this is 11/32 of tread depth. This is 12, a little bit deeper, but I predict that the Falken will be a bit quieter. The tread is a bit stiffer. The rubber seems a little stiffer than this General and most other snow tires. It's just a unique tread pattern that I've never really seen before. Let's get them both pointing in the same direction here. So Falken, I said it was stiffer. The siping is a little less dense than you would see on other tires. So I think in the dry, this tire is probably going to be, you know, probably better handling, probably feel a little bit better with steering. Deep snow, maybe that's where it's going to suffer a little bit, like over a tire like this. It does have good channels, but it doesn't have the V groove that most other snow tires have. So it's got this solid center block. It doesn't have the channels through it for, you know, collecting snow. And I think that's probably why they call it the F-Ice 1. Ice tires typically have siping, but they are not treaded for extremely deep digging through snow. This would be, you know, this is considered a deep snow tire, or at least what I would consider to be a deep snow tire. There's huge channels. It's just deep, it's very soft compound, and it's aggressive. Whereas this is a bit smoother, especially over the surface. It would handle better in the dry and wet, I predict, again. Nobody really knows because there aren't any reviews of this tire. But sidewalls seem, you know, pretty much identical. They're not really, one's not more stiffer than the other. Yeah, I hope to get these, you know, maybe later in the year, I hope to get some impressions of these on the road. That would be nice just to see, because they're very cheap. They're positioned as a budget snow tire where I'm from here. And I mean, they're 20 or 30 bucks cheaper than the General's per tire. And that you know, if these are, you know, nearly as good, that's a great deal. And I'd love to recommend them for more people to put in their car. But right now, I just don't know. Brother-in-law was looking for a deal on a tire. He's never bought snow tires before. So this is guaranteed to be better than the all seasons he's got already. So I thought we'd take a shot and do them, and maybe I can get some info on them. So let me know if you have any questions. I'd be happy to answer them if I can. Have a good one.